What are we asking? We're asking for the exclusion on section 3103. We're asking for a different, a reasonable treatment on section 3401. 3403, and we are asking to be very careful with the Senate version where it affects the intellectual property. Mm-hmm. So basically, in general terms, our ask is Puerto Rico is part of the U.S. Okay. One. Second, Puerto Rico should be treated with justice.
Okay.
And third, we are calling and we are letting know every representative and every senator that this bill is not helping the U.S. And it's not natural that you have a U.S. Congress trying to fix our financial problems by special act promesa, and then this bill destroyed the economy. It's not normal that you have a Congress and a U.S. Executive branch trying to help Puerto Rico after Maria, and then this bill, the effect of this bill is to destroy our economy. So it's a matter of discussion, education, and we hope that at the end of this process, we could get a bill that will conclude on positive terms to Puerto Rico.
Okay, what would happen if in the next 6 to 7 months, like you said, that there's that amount of time, what would happen if the concerns aren't met?
Well, you have to realize that after Maria, we have huge problems and challenges in the tourism sector. We have huge problems and challenges in the small private sector. So if before the manufacturing was basically the center of all activities, now it's by far more important. So if after all this process, the conclusion is a law that affects Puerto Rico, then we're going to be affected.
You said before that it could be the next hurricane. Why?
Well, I think we already explained that. I mean, we have first a financial catastrophe.
Uh-huh.
Then we got a natural catastrophe, and this will be the third catastrophe.
Would it mean the closing of companies? Would it mean
greater
migration?
Or it will mean, for example, a debt that won't be paid. It will be, for example, a huge migration, which is not bad for the state because the Puerto Ricano is a great, great human resources. It's legal migration, so help them to grow. But Puerto Rico will collapse.
And then finally, you've been working for the past 3 years. You've been lobbying Congress. You've been having meetings with, lawmakers. And these amendments got into the tax code, surprisingly for you. How do you explain that? Because I know you talked about it before, but you spent all this time lobbying, and now this is here.
When the Congress act in terms of putting together a law, they build this for a mass, the total mass. So in the process of exclusions and amendments and what have you, is where we have to fine tune this bill. And we believe that we will be able to do it. What I mentioned is that even though the executive branch changed, the legislative branch, the Congress didn't, the leadership didn't. So all the investment we did, visiting the Congress, educating them, okay, going through PROMESA with them, going through Maria with them, should pay results. From the project to the law, we hope all the education, all the investment will pay benefits.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.